Sorry, Dewey, I didn't mean to wake you up. Good evening, everybody. Thank you for being here. This is a New Carlisle City Council meeting, Monday, September 21st, 2015, 7 p.m. Now call to order, please.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Here.
Mr. McIntyre?
Here.
Mr. Reynolds?
Here.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Here.
Mr. Kraybacher?
Yep.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Here.
Six members present.
Thank you. Okay, before we continue, if you have a cell phone, if you would, please turn it off. Put it on vibrate tonight so we don't interrupt the meeting, if you'd be so kind. And again, thank you for being here. Now, if you'd please stand, we're going to have the invocation by Councilman Ethan Reynolds.
Bow your heads, please. Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight. We come before you tonight for your guidance, wisdom, and peace. You are the source of all that is good. You are the source of all of our blessings. Father God, we ask for you to put your hand in this meeting and bless it. We ask that you guide us and give us direction at our meeting so that it's full of wisdom, productivity, and respect for one another. Thank you for helping us to accomplish our work and our goals at this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Now, if you join me, please, for the pledge, we'll use the flag in the back. I'll be able to talk tonight sometime.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
You started it. I said you started this. I had this moment.
We'll get there. It'll work. Action on the minutes, regular meeting on September the 8th, 2015.
So moves.
Second.
Any questions or additions or subtractions? Everybody's happy with it?
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Kraybacher?
Yes.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Passed 6-0.
Thank you. Communications, any tonight?
None this evening, sir.
Thank you. And we will go into the city manager's report, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of council, members of the public. I'd like to start off our city manager's report with our finance director, Ms. Harris.
Thank you, Mr. Bridge, mayor, council, and members of the public. This is our August 15th financial report, and we'll start out with the total revenue that we received for the month of August, $656,750.77. Total expenditures for the month of August is $349,105.64. So our year-to-date revenue collected is $3,498,917.70. And our year-to-date total expenditures was $3,013,813.15. The interest on the income tax, I broke that out this month. The general fund has collected $101,660.57 for the month of August. And the new 0.5% police income tax for August collected $8,935.48. So our year-to-date for the general fund on our income tax collection is $775,324.07. And our year-to-date for our 0.5% police income tax levy is $8,978.70. Next page, I put a little memo from our new tax administrator, and she put in some information on the tax collection. Some of the increase, we are up about 71% for the month of August compared to last year. And most of that is due the July income tax that we would have collected fell in and was received in August. So that's what brought our month of August up quite a bit. She has also been able to put out a lot of notices for non-filers. And she's probably put out over several thousand of them. And that is just to remind the people that we have on record whether they still should be filing, haven't filed. So we're getting a great response back from that, and the collections are up in, on that work effort that she's been doing. And then the other interesting, the last page, I think, on my report that wanted to update on the pool. So our revenue for August, for the month of pool, or the month of August for the pool revenue was $5,214.57. And I believe we ran the pool till August, middle of August, 19th. Expenditures for the month of August were $15,496.83. But I wanted to break it down. Going the very first month that we opened up the pool, we did have a net profit at the end of the month of June of $10,436.18. July, after the revenue and expenditures, we had a net loss of $3,280.91. And then for this reporting month of August, we had a net loss of $10,282.26. So for everything that I've received in and everything on expense-wise that I have as of August 31st, the pool right now is showing a total negative loss of $3,126.99. And that's a big difference from this time last year. I expect a few more utilities to come in and a very minimal expense, but by next month, I'm hoping it's complete. Any questions?
Yes, Mr. Willis, go ahead.
I was looking at the attorney fees for the month of June to July, and I saw that they had increased almost double. Is there a certain reason for that? Maybe Mr. Bridge can answer this. It went from $6,000 to $11,708.
That was a fire investigation with a lot of that was billed for that month.
So she was actually in every meeting we were.
She had her hand in some of the investigation, absolutely. There was also some Kennedy Trust stuff in there and also some workers' comp claims, I do believe, as well.
Okay, so that's almost an increase because I realized we were paying more for our attorney than we were for our deputy sheriffs.
Sure.
So that kind of freaked me out a little bit.
Sure.
And then my next one is, are we paying mileage for certain employees, or is there Amy Garman on here and she got paid mileage and I've not seen that before? And then so I was kind of wondering about that.
If a city vehicle isn't available for a seminar or for a class that they have to take, then we do the standard mileage reimbursement.
Okay,
right?
Just wanted to double check. Oh, and then I have actually one last one. I have it all written down here. What city property has bed bugs?
It's at the firehouse.
The firehouse. Is that taken care of now?
We've had two treatments.
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure.
Anybody else? Sarah, thank you for the report. Thank you for the pool report. And hopefully we don't get many more bills in for the pool. Thank you. Appreciate that.
And moving on with the city manager's report, our service discussion with our service director, Mr. Kitko.
Thank you, Mr. Bridge. Good evening, Mayor, Council, members of the public. I just have a couple quick items I'd like to give you an update on. Prentice Drive Phase 2 project will begin September 28th. And as I put out in previous meetings, that is a total reconstruction from the end of Phase 1 up to Kennison, new curb and gutter, new street, and some new storm dry wells to help with the drainage. They estimate to be in there. It's a 60-day project. However, after our pre-con meeting, they think it'll probably be less than 30 days. And next item is a veteran meter change. Their communications had sent a letter off to the New Carlisle News. They had published it, and then they've been out to about 100 to 120 homes. They've been putting packets that give a letter explaining what they're doing, why they're doing, to move meters that are inside the house to outside the house. I've been getting a couple calls that the city wasn't notifying them or whatever of veterans' work. Well, they have went out and notified. There are some upset customers. So far in the beginning, they want to keep their meter inside, from what I understand, but I've been just explaining to them, if you guys get any calls, that it's not New Carlisle requesting this. It's a veterans utility. All we do is do locates for where they need to know our water and sewer, but it's all their project for their infrastructure. So I've been just trying to I've been taking calls and then passing them on to the contractor or veteran. But I just wanted to let everybody know there's about 100 addresses or so that are getting this meter change out project. So if you could just bear with them. Veteran, as you know, has been putting all kinds of commercials out for infrastructure upgrades, meter projects, things like that. We will have Monday or Tuesday some street sweeping around a lot of our main drags this year to get those cleaned up. And other than that, we're about finally done dura patching for potholes. Grass did slow down for us some, and we've been doing some other repairs. A lot of work has been going on in Smith Park with our trees. We still have a lot to do with that. We've had a couple of generous tree companies working with us, and we're continuing. And obviously, when that project is done, I have stuff in the works for that. So, but that is all I have. I can entertain any questions on that or anything else.
Yes, Mr. Craybrock.
Two things. The sign up there, Smith Park sign. Any updates on paint or anything to do with that? You're waiting for commercial paint, last time I heard.
We got a quote in to get the face part of it done with one of the local businesses here in town. I do believe that Mr. Mayor has that, and she will look at negotiating some prices on that.
That's not really for painting it. All that is for that silhouette of the people up on top.
The paint right now is, depending on what color we want to go with.
Could anybody start scraping at and go at, you know, get deck paints and just paint that?
Sure. You know what colors that you guys want to do?
Well, the same color as it is, you know.
Well, the gold paint that's on there is extremely expensive.
Well,
so.
Again, I don't think we have to do gold paint for that. Some type of a yellow, bright yellow will work just as well. It's what I did to the sign down.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, I've still got some of that. That would work. Just like you said, John, it needs to be scraped and primed, especially where it says Smith Park, that big long one. That needs to be primed up.
So anybody can do that, though. Do they have to get permission from the... The reason is there was a Facebook thing, you know. I can't help it. But so anyway, so some people are saying, you know, about the sign, and they would like to help with the sign.
Sure.
And I said, and I put on there, hang on it for a little bit. So do we have to get permission from the city to do that? That's what I'm asking.
No, if anybody wants to go out there and scrape it, just clean up the paint chips.
Okay.
Absolutely. We love community volunteers.
And then I don't have to know who it is.
It would be nice to know who it is, yes. Is it something that we...
I mean, nothing set in stone. Once someone, whoever has the paint, then we would probably want to chip. But if we chip too early, then we don't get someone, whoever... We have plenty of volunteers, I understand, that want to do it. And we have plenty of people that have wanted to donate some money towards it. But I think the last I heard was the quality of paint and the color of it. So, but it hasn't got back to, I think myself, that they wanted to go back with that color that fades a lot and go with something maybe a little different, maybe a little brighter or something. That was the last that I remember, is who was really going to take the lead on it and what color that they want to go with. I mean, because we're open to the suggestions of what everybody else wants, but I don't think there really has been anything put out said, okay, here, what color, what day do you want to start, and let's go ahead and do it.
Another thing is, there's some history now that you have for the water meters. Has that changed anything?
Has the what?
The water meters, the new water meters. You know, you've got some history. You got a couple months underneath the belt.
We do have a couple months. We're still working on the different types of things that they can do. So we're trying to get that evolved. It's still learning the software. How do you put all that data together? Because there is tons. I've actually helped quite a few people with the information as far as particular individual, but as far as the general water consumption, other items, we haven't just got that far yet. We've been dealing with more customer service, customer satisfaction with it than our own usage right now.
Okay.
Yes.
Randy or Howie, I don't know who this would be for. A couple weeks ago, there was a lot of complaints going through town about, I believe the company, I was at home when it was going on, North American. They were going door to door for an electric company. And I guess they, like I said, I didn't see them, but they were going door to door and they were asking people to see their electric bill to switch them over to, you know, okay, so that's right. Okay, so, but my question is, from what I hear, that some of them were pretty blunt and kind of forceful about getting your information. Is there any way we can deter that kind of behavior from people who are getting permits to go door to door in our town? I mean, say if a company comes in and we get complaints at the city office, they get a ding or something on the file, and after they get one or two marks or something, they just don't let them back? Or, I mean, what would be a good solution for that? Because we don't want citizens getting harassed.
Sure, no, that's a good point. Well, the first thing they're supposed to do is come get a peddler's license to do that in the city. Some people do, some companies don't. We can tweak it and try to keep track of what companies get dinged and what company, you know, does a great job. I did hear that last week, that there was a company going around town and kind of being a little forceful. If they don't have a peddler's license, you know, we ask what the last location they're at. I'll get in the car, go look for them. They're pretty good about getting out sometimes, especially mm-hmm. if they see somebody coming after them. Mm-hmm. So it's something that probably could actually be tweaked a little bit better for keep track of who's doing good and who's doing not. Absolutely.
When it was in its early stages, when we had, I think, the first company or two come in and start selling their product, we actually did boot them out. We had representatives in and said, you've got to leave the city, because I guess they were being, not just typical sales tactics, they were being, I mean, like, overly aggressive.
Yeah, last year they were, like, telling people they had to sign up, because Ms. Jens had sent out a memo saying, like, they're barred from the city, if you remember correctly.
Yeah.
You said the city can legally kick them out permanently?
Yeah, I mean, we just don't have to issue a peddler's license, okay. You know, for probably just a good reason. I mean, we had many complaints on them.
Okay.
And it's something, honestly, is this something that we even want to happen in our town? I mean, we don't have to allow these people to go door to door, you know, especially with some of our elderly citizens. Mm-hmm. You know, we can put some in the ordinance that says, no, we just won't allow you to do it. You know, so as a council and as a citizen and as a community, maybe we can get together and brainstorm, is this something that we really want?
That's a good.
A peddler's license only, what, $5? $5, I do believe.
For each, for,
yeah. So it's not like we're losing a lot of money on it.
Looking that maybe into the near future, all of us, maybe
sure.
If we got a few extra minutes sometime.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Sure. Anyone else? Any questions? Thank you. Mr. Kitko, thank you.
All right, moving on with the city manager's report, the planning department monthly report, which I will gladly do. I'm excited for this one. So bear with me until I get to the good stuff. Code enforcement activity, looks like 60% of all violations or yellow tags issued were surrounded around grass, which is typical for this time of year. We had some inoperable cars, about 8% recreational vehicle. Trash was up a little bit, 17%. Jim, our code enforcement officer, has a great eye when it comes to that kind of stuff. And noise actually is something that he's been tagging people for as well. Quiet hours in the city do begin at 10 o'clock. Moving on, New Carlisle is open for business. So maybe some of you guys have noticed a new business right next to CVS. It's called Gent Mechanical. He opened up about in July. Right now they're doing some renovations on the building, so he's technically not in there yet 100%. But the nature of the business is heating and air. The phone number is 845-1111. Hours are Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. And a fun fact about Gent Mechanical is that he has an A-plus rating with their Better Business Bureau. So if you need any HVAC work, please keep it local and give Gent Mechanical a call. Now, this is what I'm excited about. What's all the action around town? Many of you probably noticed there's a lot of activity going around town right now. So just bear with me. I'm going to go over four projects. Two of these are pretty visible, and the other two you'll see action on in the coming weeks. First one is Speedway. Many of you have noticed they've gotten down to three houses, and they've actually tore down the old Speedway. It's a pretty big site right now. If you look at it with everything down, they got some fencing around the perimeter of the construction site, but they are redeveloping that current location into a Speedy Cafe. If you're unfamiliar with Speedy Cafe, please get on the internet and Google it. It'll be a great place to stop in and get a variety of things to eat, drink, or just stop in and get your gas. So we're all very excited about the cafe option. It's going to be about 4,000 square feet. The new build is going to have about, I think it's 6 to 8 dispenser islands. Don't quote me on the 6 now that I think about it. It has 24 parking spaces. It's going to have 3 driveways. There's going to be one coming off Church, one on Main, and one on Lake. So access in and out is going to be pretty easy. The Church Street driveway is really for local traffic, so keep that in mind. It's going to have attractive landscaping, a dumpster enclosure, and fencing along the southern border so it won't interrupt the houses that are adjacent to the property. The area redevelopment is about 1.038 acres, and as we mentioned before, Speedway did purchase the housing units that have already been torn down. Van Crest, AKA Daveview, will be undergoing a $5 million expansion here in the coming months. Part of this expansion's called for numerous demolitions. I think they filed probably about maybe 12 different demolition permits a couple weeks ago. They'll also be constructing new buildings to house their current needs. A planning board hearing will be set forth in October, and after that is set, we will have more information coming along. Hardy Holder Oil is growing as well. You know, I think in October 2012, they had just began that process. I remember I was in on that planning board meeting when they first got their plans approved for that one. So it is great to know that he is growing. He will be adding an addition onto the rear of his property. Again, a planning board hearing will be set in October, and it's going to be the same night as the Van Crest planning board hearing. But after that hearing is set, we'll have some more information as well. AutoZone, which is the old CVS building, has a lot of activity going on it as well. Right now, they are in the interior gutting that out and getting that spec'd out for their needs. Once they are done with the inside of that building, we'll then see some activity on the outside. They're going to brand that with AutoZone stuff. I do believe there's going to be a big old red stripe down the side, and of course the AutoZone logo everywhere we can see. Again, we are very excited about having that brand in town, another nationally recognized company in our great little city. They are looking for a target date of opening around Thanksgiving. So I was excited to tell everybody about these four projects because all four of them are pretty big, and it just goes to show that our town, we are surviving, we are thriving, we are actually growing, because none of this would be happening if they didn't see any progress in this city of ours. So please visit these businesses when they're done and stop in and say hi. Vacant housing for the month, the same as last month, 80, 73 of those are residential and 7 are commercial. And I do believe that is all I have for the planning and zoning discussion, so any questions?
Were the old tanks removed?
I do believe they were.
Not yet.
Not yet?
Not
they
yet.
They will be.
They will be.
Do you want one of them?
Huh?
Do you want one?
No, I got one.
Okay. Wasn't expecting that answer, do we? But we're good.
Mr. McIntyre?
Speaking of targeted completion dates, and I know you've gone over this before, but what's the general time frame we're looking at for the new Speedway to be done?
Speedway usually goes about 3 months.
3 months.
So they turn around pretty quick, and that's from the date of demolition. So I think they've been at it for about a week. And I tell you what, I remember driving past the house one day last week and the week before, and they had just started demoing the house, and I came back through a couple hours later, and I think two of them were gone already.
Sure.
So they're not messing around.
Right.
You know, I'm very excited for the Speedway. It's going to be a great addition to our city. I'm more excited about the Speedy Cafe. It's the eating option in town. I mean, come on.
You're allowed.
Absolutely.
Unlimited Mountain Dew, huh?
You know, we're going to leave my personal answer out of that.
Are you over?
Yeah.
If they add on the back, how far are they going to go? Because they will be getting pretty close to encroaching upon the cemetery, will they not?
I'm sure they will. I'll be honest with you, I haven't really looked over the plans yet due to the fact of my absence last week. I really don't like to talk about the specifics of that until after the planning board meeting, because I don't know what the planning board is going to approve or deny.
Okay.
He does have some room to work with back there, and depending on what his setback is, and he's zoned light industrial. So light industrial setbacks are similar to central business, where they're either 5 feet or 10 feet. So the company he's working with is Winco. They're very familiar with our codes. I'm sure everything will be fine. But again, since it is a physical development in the city, the planning board have to approve that overall.
Okay.
I don't see any issues though.
Speedway, have you heard anything at all about the one on the east side that's going to happen?
But that's the million-dollar question.
Okay.
We don't know. I would hope they keep it open. At the last planning board meeting that we had with them, I kind of picked the gentleman who's representing them. Said, hey, if they do decide to keep it open, can you just do a little aesthetic work to it? I know they recently paved blacktop over there, but a little love can be given on the outside. I think they might keep it open for a while.
I mean, they
get a lot of traffic coming from north or south off 235. I would rather them keep it open than to sell it for a discount smoke place or something like that. You know?
Thank you.
Sure.
Mr. Reynolds, you have a question?
Yeah, with the Speedway building, the new building, are they going to fix the sidewalks or put in new sidewalks where the sidewalks are now? Or
I don't think they're going to touch the sidewalk.
Any sidewalk is damaged. If it was already good and in good condition, they weren't going to touch it.
Okay.
But they're going to have a lot of rework. Where the two approaches are closest to the intersection, those go away. So I have a feeling they're going to be replacing more than what I think because the equipment running over it. But it's not set up for a whole new, brand new.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure. Thank you.
Well, anyone else?
It'll be quick. Okay, round two. I also had a question. I just thought of it for the RD holder expansion. Mm-hmm. When they initially went in there, they put a row of trees or planted some trees between themselves and the cemetery. And it looks fantastic, and they did a great job. I want to thank them for doing it. At the board meeting, when this comes up, I know we're not in specifics right now, but maybe bring that up again if they're going to be encroaching more in the cemetery from a different way, thinking about trees.
Sure.
If possible.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Not a problem.
And just FYI, I have not had any complaints as far as like with the cemetery or any calls down to Greg about their building. It's a fabulous looking building. They keep their lawn looking like a golf course. So I think the initial perception was going to be negative, sort of, but it's been positive.
I do have one question for Mr. Kitko yet. The bridge, we forgot to mention the bridge and how they're doing on the bridge.
New Carlisle Pike Bridge. Scheduled date right now still, from what I understand, September 30th to open, and still weather pending. As far as Heritage of Flight Festival, I still think we're going to keep the new detour, which is going way around. Even if the bridge opens back up, we're going to keep that.
Anyone else? Any other questions?
And moving on, our fire discussion with our interim fire chief, Chief Ritter.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, members of council, members of the public. The New Carlisle Fire Department responded to 62 calls for medical assistance and 4 fire-related calls so far in the month of September. The fire department has reinstated 3 former employees, with 2 being residents of New Carlisle, and 1 who was employed in a part-time program residing outside the response area. All 3 are firefighter paramedics. We have also brought on 1 firefighter EMT who also lives in the city. All 3 individuals living in the city are available for pay-per-call as well as part-time program. We also met this week with the members of the Heritage of Flight Committee and confirmed that we are providing the support that was expected from the division. And lastly, the division will be hosting an open house for Fire Prevention Week on September 8th. And all members of the public are invited to come. We'll have
Is that October the 8th?
I'm sorry. Yeah, I wrote September. Yeah, October the 8th. Thank you.
Thank you. Just say I missed it otherwise.
Yeah, so did I.
Rewind.
Any questions for the chief?
Yes, sir.
Chief Fitter, how's morale doing now?
Absolutely. Never say great fire service. Doing very well.
Good to know. Thank you.
Anyone else?
Mr. Mayor.
Questions? Yes, please.
I just wanted to thank Chief Ritter. I mean, he's really stepped up to the plate, him and Assistant Chief Ward Mueller as well. They're looking at a department that we all know this morale was pretty much at rock bottom with no chance of repair. So this gentleman has really stepped up. I've talked with him a few times privately in the office. I could not be more impressed. So I wanted to say thank you at a council meeting for really doing service to the community that you obviously love.
I do.
Sure.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else? Yes, Mr. Corbin.
Any applications, Randy?
We have received 1 from a gentleman from in Lima. I had originally wanted that to go out last week, but it's been the job posting has been put off. And I was talking to Councilman Reynolds outside too, is I wanted at least a week for that fire department to get back to normal instead of saying, have you got any applications? When's it going to go out? You know, and I think that first week we saw a great return to normal in a very short amount of time. So we'll be looking to get that ad out here soon. Hopefully tomorrow, Wednesday or Thursday. When it does come out, I'll send a memo out to council, let you guys know what paper it's in, and then, you know, how we're going to tackle the applicants afterwards.
Sure. Okay. Anyone else? Thanks, Chief. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
And moving on with our police discussion, Deputy Allender.
Okay, I'm going to pass out. Okay, thanks. There you go. Thanks. So I just received this, but this is only my second meeting. So I'll start out by saying, you know, I'm Rachel Allender. I've been with the Sheriff's Department for going on 4 years, and I'm new to New Carlisle. I've been out here since June, and I will say we've just been overwhelmed with support from the community, and you know, everybody's been really, really great. With that being said, we have our August monthly report. For reports in the city, it's been a total of 53 reports. 30 of those reports have come from a county deputy and 23 from a New Carlisle deputy. There's been a total of 1,265 miles patrolled in the city, and that's containing 63 miscellaneous calls and 6 follow-up investigations. As far as traffic within the city goes, 36 traffic stops have been made, 13 citations have been issued, and that's including 1 OVI arrest, a driving under suspension, 2 parking citations, a non-injury accident, and 1 injury accident. With the arrest for this month, there have been 2 warrants filed for individuals who live within the city, and no arrests have been made that's adult or juvenile. Kind of a breakdown of the calls that have been taken. There's been 1 assault, a break-in and entering, 7 thefts, a vandalism, 16 911 hangups within the city, a telephone harassment, domestic violence, 3 domestic violence verbal calls, 4 calls for a peace officer, 6 alarms, and 19 assists. A couple things just to remember, the Heritage of Flight, which they mentioned parade, will be on Saturday, October the 3rd, and that some of the city streets will be blocked off. As far as my understanding right now, they are going to have extra deputies out here kind of helping with traffic. Trick or Treat is going to be held on Saturday, October the 31st from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. And attached to your pamphlet there, there are going to be 3 crime reports from the Clark County Sheriff's Office, which just kind of gives you a comparison of the different townships and the crime throughout the, you know, this year compared to last year.
Thank you, Deputy. Questions? Mr. McIntosh.
Ma'am, I won't put you on the spot because I know you're new. I just want to say thank you for being here and all the work you do. And I hope you find this to be a great community to do your work in. Thanks for keeping everyone safe. And if you could you pass along a thanks to the Sheriff's Department for having Beggars Night on Halloween? I know that's been something people wanted for the past 4 years.
Yes, I will pass it on, thank you.
Anyone else?
On a Saturday.
Yes.
It's like the last Saturday, I think, of the month.
Go ahead, Rick.
Yes, welcome to New Carlisle.
Thank you.
Everything is set up for the festival and the parade, everything, you've got deputies ready and everything.
Yep, I know that they're going to do some extra patrol. They're going to have deputies from the county. I think they're going to have some reserves out here. And then they're also going to have some deputies on foot. I believe for that day, they're going to have both of the New Carlisle deputies, so myself and Deputy Cruz, out. That way we can make ourselves seen in the public. People can, you know, if anybody has questions, we can introduce ourselves to the members of the community who haven't yet got to meet us yet.
Okay, next question. Are you taking Sergeant Underwood's place? Are you going to be now the police administrator?
Not to my knowledge. I was just informed by Sergeant Underwood about 10 minutes ago that I was, or 10 minutes before the meeting, that I was supposed to be here. He was on vacation, okay. So I think there was a miscommunication on whether or not he would be back in time. So, to my knowledge, no.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Anyone else? Thank you, Deputy. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Deputy. And moving on, under City Manager Report, informational items. Request for media outlets. We had some information come across, requested information about the Twin Creek Sheriff's Sales. We also had public records requests for all communications between city staff and the fire investigators, and communications between certain city staff, and also a copy of the contract between the city and the fire investigations, questions about the fire department operations, and also questions about road work in the city. So that was all the information requested from the media. So moving on with this.
Mr. Bridge, before you go on, you mentioned Twin Creeks. Could you give what you know at this point, Twin Creeks, if you would?
I will here in a minute, because it's actually number 4 on my list.
I beg your pardon?
Not a problem.
I just need to have, yeah, I need to know how to read.
So. And for number two there on the list, key to the city presentation for Heritage of Flight Committee will be at the next council meeting at 10 on October 5th. So if you want to come and say thank you for all the years of hard work and dedication that has that committee has brought to our city, it would be greatly appreciated to show up and show your report. And also to remind everybody, the Heritage of Flight will be in the Ohio Magazine as their featured events of the month. So that was something that Councilman Zambach had requested that I do. I contacted him out, and it is in the Ohio Magazine. I have not physically seen it, but I did hear word that it was the event of the month. So that's awesome to have that exposure in a statewide magazine. Yeah. So hopefully it draws a few more hundred people up down to our city. Keep Cart Clowney Beautiful. We have received a grant of $250, and that is to get bulbs to plant around town. So I actually updated our city website today asking for volunteers. I do believe it was October 17th that we're going to ask volunteers. And how we want to do it is, and we're always open for opinions, but we really want to tackle our signs that welcome people into our city and also the cemetery sign. So we want to look at making rock flower beds around some of these signs, put some dirt in there, and then actually placing the bulbs that we already got in the mail, and then beautifying all the entrances to our town. So again, October 17th, if you have a few hours to commit, just look at the city website or give us a call at the city building to volunteer your time. It would be greatly appreciated. Mr. Mayor, Twin Creeks update.
See, now I can read it. I've highlighted it. It makes a difference.
That's all I got to do. No problem. September 11th was the second of the last sheriff sales. We had one on August 28th and also on September 11th. The parcels are in a community reutilization program, and stipulations of that program states that it has to go through two sheriff sales. One parcel sold at the first sheriff sale, and I do believe it was 502 Colony Trail, for just about $4,000 or $5,000. And then the remaining parcels did not sell at all at either of the sheriff sales. So what that means to us, and I'm going to be very vague because I'm still getting some questions clarified from the county, but we have not got the deeds. They have not called us to go record the deed yet. And that's another reason why I don't like to speak too advanced, because we don't have the deed yet. That makes me nervous. But once we do have those, we'll go record them, and then we can sell them, and then we can recoup some of the money that we put in for grass cutting. I want to know if we can get any other money back for other things that we pay for. So when I have the clear answer from the county, we'll have a full report to the council and the citizens. But it is a good thing that none of them sold, because now we can recoup some of the money that we've lost. Moving forward, this is a great move for the city. We're looking at 25 parcels. One parcel did not make it on either share sale, and that was because some paperwork was mishandled by our previous law director. So that will be on the share sales next round. I do believe that one also would fall in the community reutilization program as well. So if it doesn't sell, the city would be able to sell that and recoup some of the money lost. We did have a prior agreement in place with a previous buyer. I plan on revisiting that with that potential buyer and seeing if this potential buyer is still interested in buying in the bulk. But for a city, it's one, we're very close to having one less thing happen to deal with. So looking to move forward, you know, it's a good step for us. So I'm happy to say that there's light at the end of the tunnel. Any questions on Twin Creeks before I go any further? No? All right, Moorefield Township Police Cruiser update. I was asked by a council member maybe a couple weeks ago to get the blue book value of it. It's about $10,000 to $11,000. So I went in and actually did that, put it on the criteria. We're purchasing it for $12,000. But that also includes a fully loaded police cruiser. That includes a dash cam, light bar, other equipment such as a DUI seat and the case. To give you an idea, the dash cam alone is probably valued at $3,000. The light bar is about $1,000. Other equipment like the DUI seat is about anywhere from $1,500 to $2,000. So we're getting a really good deal on this. I have the first half of the check that we're going to send them. We're going to pay $6,000 now, and then we're going to pay the remaining balance before December 31st of this year. But I think it's a great move for our city to get a decent, very well maintained and cared for cruiser that is fully well equipped. for such a great price.
Yes.
Randy, I remember Sergeant Underwood talking about the dash cam on that car. Will that camera be, I was thinking we heard something about it may not be compatible or something. So a software update it may need or something. Will the camera work when we get it for our needs?
The camera that's in that car will come with its own server, its own thing, so it will be a standalone. It will serve the same purpose, but the new, supposedly the ones that come on, like we're setting up the servers now for the body camera system, where you can just drive by, it downloads it auto. That won't be the case for it, so you just have to do it manually. It's got two hard drives, so there's one in it, one sitting, say, at the substation. When they come in, they take, put that one on the docking station, it automatically downloads, and they grab the other one and go. Okay. So it'll just be the difference. They won't be uncompatible with each other, but yeah, they won't be able to work on the same system.
Okay, but we'll have at least one car with onboard cam.
Sure. Gotcha. And that's a win for, that's a win for our citizens. I think, like I said, I was behind this purchase from day one, and I think it's a great asset for us to have that coming in the car.
Yep. Anyone else on that?
Okay. And I do believe that is all for the city manager report, so I'd be more than happy to entertain any questions.
All right.
We have, oh Lord. A lot. A lot. I wouldn't say it's that high. I would say anywhere from 500 to 800. Right now we have, we're in the process of getting rocks. So we did get rocks.
We got the rocks, Mayor.
There are 13 about this big around that we have at the cemetery now. We just need to get them up here. We need equipment to get them up, put them around, and then topsoil, and then go from there.
Topsoil.
We'll have the beds off here. All their needs.
We would love help making the beds as well. So it's a start from scratch project, if that helps out. Yes. But the end result is going to be fantastic.
Okay, another quick question. Mm-hmm. On Spring Street, when we do those, are you going to use a wheel server?
Probably not. I would say no to that.
Anyone else? Any questions for city manager? Go ahead.
Yeah.
If you would, please. That way we can hear you. He can hear you. The microphone. Thank you.
From Bonovich, 505 P's. I'm very concerned with our lawyer fees. We started, like it was said, 6,000, almost 12,000 next month, and all of this now is out of that 10,000 was the fire investigation. We were told that wasn't going to go over 10,000, but now some of this lawyer fee is being put to that also. So now we've got like double payments there in my book. And I would like to see some specific information on where that money goes or what they're doing for that much money. That's a lot of money. And if we're concerned about the pool losing 3,000, I think we ought to be more concerned about these lawyer fees. And also, if we go back to the thing of, we do have some lawyers in this town, and this group is from Dayton, so they might not have exactly the same feeling towards our town, shall I say? So those were two of my concerns, and I don't know how you could address those. I had asked for specific invoices before, and basically got an open page with not much on it. So I don't know who signs off on these invoices, but I do think we need a little more specific information on it.
And I understand that, but you gotta understand too, when she invoices us, she tells us especially specifically what she's doing a lot of times, and that's a lot of time is not public information.
Not specific.
If she's working for personnel,
if you just say,
she's doing
okay,
this.
She's working on this, this, and this, that doesn't give me an idea of how much time she spent on this or how much time, and we're not getting any results, it seems like, selling one. To me, that's not a great result. I'm sorry, Randy. I know you work hard.
Our law director had nothing to do with the sheriff says.
Okay.
That has nothing to do with it.
This is another thing, then. What is being done by her or them, whoever these people are?
Are you talking about our law director?
Yes, our law director.
She's been working on various things that actually she had to do because of previous issues that she had zero control over.
And I keep hearing that over and over. So when does that stop?
When they're completed. So I will be more than happy to have Lynette retract any information that's not public information off of her latest invoices and share that with you. There's been a lot of discussion about Lynette, our law director, to be honest with you. And, you know, she charges us a decent rate, $165. And I've asked a local attorney if, you know, what his rate would be, and it was more than $165. You also have years of experience that Lynette has as well, where it could take her an hour to do something, and somebody who doesn't have the experience she has, it can take them 2 hours to do. I know that number.
I still think it should be public information. There is privileged, I understand mm-hmm. that, between lawyers and clients, but we're the clients.
But she's also time doing work for, maybe it's an employee that was going through a personnel matter or a claim that is not public information. So anything that Lynette gives you and she blacks out, it's because it's not public information. If she were not to black that out, then the person can hold us liable and turn around and sue us.
I understand
us, so.
That, but what I'm getting is not even anywhere close to specifics is what mm-hmm. I'm saying. So
sure.
Not happy with it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It
I take it we must be into comments from the public at this point.
He's already here.
I had a comment or a question for Randy if we're still there.
Sure.
But it's comments from the public now. We're there. So please identify yourself.
William Lindsay, 314 North Henry Street. Mr. Bridge, you just said something that piqued my interest.
What's that?
He's talking about the attorney that works for this city. Hence, works for all of you guys and everybody in this room working on employees' work, a personal matter. Is that not the word you used, or did I misunderstand?
Maybe I said it wrong. I'm talking if somebody has to go through a PwC claim or we're fighting unemployment, things like that.
Find unemployment? File unemployment.
Unemployment benefits.
Okay.
Yes.
That takes an attorney to file for that?
I'm not saying she filed for it, but she might have been asked her opinion on something.
Maybe I'm misunderstanding what you're saying. You're asking the attorney about somebody filing for unemployment, or city employees getting laid off, asking our attorney a question about filing unemployment?
I would be asking the attorney questions.
Okay. So it's not a city worker or city employee that was laid off, because that's kind of the way I took it when you said that.
Sure.
Okay. Again, I'm going to go back to the attorney fees. In June, she got almost, $11,700. That was paid in August.
$11,718.15.
Was paid in August? Why wasn't
it
paid
the cut was
in July?
On 8/7, so that would have been her July invoice.
Well, it says here, June Attorney Services.
Well, what is her June invoice?
Why is it paid in August and not July?
The check was cut August 7th. It was cut probably a week after I received it.
Okay, so she don't invoice the next month for her services previous month?
I'll usually get her invoice about 30 days after the end of the month.
Okay.
And there's two in the...
Well, then on 8/18, she gave you the July attorney services fees, and that check was cut within 18 days of receiving it, I assume.
I cut them as soon as I can get them in the accounts payable, as soon as I receive
okay.
them. And she's been pretty consistent about sending them when she has the services done at the end of the month, and she puts them in the mail. That one, obviously, we receive later.
Okay.
So there's two in that month, and that's why I put the month of service in there, so we could see what that check was for. So we have her June attorney's bill, the $11,700, and we have her July.
Okay.
I have not received August to date.
Okay.
I understand that.
Okay. The pool, gentleman up there. What are we going to do with the pool? I remember a conversation a few months ago that the pool lost money. You're going to close the pool. And before you answer that question, I have one more question from Ms. Harris. Mrs. Harris, how much money did we start off with from the city funds to fund the pool before it ever opened? My memory tells me it's somewhere around $36,000.
No, no, no. We cleared our debt last year. The pool opened up at a zero. We put $300 out for petty cash.
Okay.
And everything's been recorded when it opened up in June.
Okay. But I've seen in here on your financial stuff that there was $81,000 earmarked this year for the pool.
No.
No.
You wouldn't have saw that. There's a $36,000, from the best of my memory, holding for a transfer from the general fund if it was needed based upon what we transferred the year before.
Okay.
That money will only, when we get this close, that's how much money will come out of the general fund to get that back to zero for this year. But we have to appropriate using our best guess of what we have. $81,000 was your total last year of income and expenses.
Okay.
And of a total, we brought in about $40,000 cash. We had about $80,000 expense, and we brought over about $40,000 from the general fund. Those are round numbers without me having my report.
Okay.
This year we put in, I believe, $36,000 or $38,000 on hold out of the general fund's budget, so it would be there if the pool needed it to transfer to cover that obligation. Right now we haven't moved any of the money into it. I want to wait until it, you know.
So $36,000 still sitting there waiting to be
correct
spent.
It's on hold. We have to make sure that that money's available when we obligated to do our budget.
That's the figure I was talking about. I thought it had already been transferred to the pool.
No, it's
and
still.
Because I was going to say, if that's true, then the $3,000 is not really right. It should be more like $39,000.
What'll happen when I get the DP&L bill and any other little ones that might still be out there, when I get that final total of what the money needs to be transferred from the general fund, then I'll go to council with our paperwork and we'll get the transfer done and we'll get that back to zero. And then we'll know exactly how much of a loss. It will be a loss. We're already there.
Yeah.
But it's not like the $40,000, $38,000 loss, meaning the money that the general fund transferred over to cover it last year. So this one's have done a lot better. But
still a loss.
It's still a loss. It's still a loss, and it still comes out of the general fund. Correct.
Now, you gentlemen can answer my question on what are we going to do with the pool since there was a loss. Because based on the conversation this council had a few months ago, if there was a loss, the pool would be dealt with for next year.
That's Mr. Lindsay, we have not had the final on it yet. When we have that, we will definitely talk on it at that point, and then we'll find out what we're planning on doing. But thank you. Anybody else like to speak tonight? Okay.
I have one more comment if you don't mind.
You've been past the 5 minutes. I've been very lenient with you.
I just wanted to welcome Chief Ritter to his new position, taking the head of the fire department. Hopefully he'll straighten it up. He's already got rid of the bugs. He's already did a lot more than, I think, than previous had. And welcome to Deputy Allender also.
Thank you. All right, shall we go on? Committee reports, any tonight?
None this evening, sir.
Okay. Resolutions, we have one. You would, please, sir.
Resolution 15-05R, public hearing in action tonight. A resolution accepting the amounts and rates as determined by the Budget Commission and authorizing the necessary tax levies and certifying them to the county auditor.
Council.
Mayor.
Yes.
Motion to adopt resolution 15-05.
Second.
And Mr. Craybacher on the second.
And an explanation of this resolution. It's a yearly resolution, and it's just basically how it reads. It's us for to accept the rates as determined by the Budget Commission for the upcoming
housekeeping, as Mr. Zambach likes to say all the time.
Sure.
Any questions? Anyone? Call for the vote, please.
Mr. Mike Lowry?
Yes.
Mayor McLaughlin?
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre?
Yes.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes.
Mr. Rick Lowry?
Yes.
Mr. Craybacher?
Yes.
Passed 6-0.
Thank you. And if you would continue, if you would, please, when you're ready.
Ordinance 15-41, introduction, public hearing, and action on 10-5-15. An ordinance authorizing the city manager to enter into a contract for the purchase of propane gas.
Thank you. Other business. Mr. Zambach is out of town. We need to excuse him. Somebody would please make a motion.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes.
Motion to excuse Mr. Zambach.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion on that? Whenever you're ready, sir.
Mr. Rick Lowry.
Yes.
Mr. Krabacher.
Yes.
Mr. Mike
yes.
Lowry. Mayor McLaughlin.
Yes.
Mr. McIntyre.
It wasn't the same without him tonight. Yes.
I know. I don't have to listen to the tape and try to figure out if I can hear him or not.
There you go.
We didn't miss it. Mr. Reynolds.
Yes.
He is excused 6-0.
Thank you. Mr. Mike Lowry would like to talk on the festival now, if you would, please.
Yes, the festival's coming up, everybody. We've talked about it a couple times, October 2nd through the 4th. I think everybody knows the drill. Friday night will start the car show. The street will close at noon on Main Street, so keep that in mind when you're coming into town from work or anything like that. The street will close down at noon on Friday, October
2nd.
October 2nd.
Second.
It looked like you had a question.
Is that going to be there at Domino's?
Domino's to
on
Speed.
Main Street.
Yeah, on Main Street. Domino's to Speedway. You know, the band will be playing that night. You know, food, rides for the kids. Saturday morning, the parade will kick off at 11, music, all kinds of events throughout the day. And then on Sunday, it'll be a really neat event that's new this year. They're going to do Blessing of the Badges. I think it's at, don't quote me, I think it's at 3 o'clock on the stage. What's Maddox's rank? Jerry Maddox.
Lieutenant.
Okay.
He's a lieutenant, isn't he, Bethel?
Oh, I don't know what his rank is.
Okay, well, anyways, Jerry Maddox came to our festival committee and pitched the idea of doing a Blessing of the Badges because I guess there's no one in the area that does it, and we told him to go ahead and go with it. And he's going to have, I guess, around 15 to 20 vehicles there on Main Street after that for Touch a Truck for the kids. Care Flight's going to do some flyovers during the ceremony. Bagpipes will be playing. It should be a really neat event, so... that weekend, 2nd through the 4th, make sure you stop by and check out all the fun.
Uh-oh, egg climbs.
Yeah.
That's it every time.
Tear jerkers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mike, I may need to see if we need some help with blocking some of the streets for
during
the parade.
Right, yeah, we've got...
We're down 3 or 4 people that I normally had as city employees helping.
Okay.
I don't have them, so I may, if I can't get enough people to help out.
Right, Ron brought it up at our last meeting. We're going to round up some adults.
I've got Bevel and my township's going to assist with that.
Amen. Very good.
Thank look you. At yeah. that. Yeah. I mean, yeah, yeah that'll help.
Look at that.
Mainly right personally, yeah, adding people to stand there. Yeah.
Solution.
Well,
that would work.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
People.
Yeah, also, you just reminded me, thank you, I forgot the Shriners won't be in the parade this year. I guess they're going to start alternating between, Bellbrook and us. I guess they were going to Bellbrook almost every year, and then they started coming to us and never went back, so Bellbrook started throwing a fuss. So they're going to alternate back and forth between parades, so they won't be here this year. Did you have something you wanted to go over?
I could speak for a minute regarding the parade.
Yeah.
I'm actually coordinating the parade along with Sharon Honeycutt.
Yeah.
Is helping me coordinate the parade. And I would say right now that we have a full house. I mean, the interest has been extremely, good. I'm getting a little nervous because I'm kind of wondering if we might have too many entries now. Flying Angels are fully prepared to be in the parade this year, weather permitting. Obviously, there's certain weather conditions where they can't bring their planes down. They're indicating they could have up to 16 planes, maybe up to 20, with extra tractors within the parade. You know that they're going to be running some antique tractors. A lot of new entries into the parade this year. There's actually a boat club, believe it or not, that kind of threw me off. A boat club that evidently there's a big effort in this area to bring back the Hydro Bowl back to the
Eastwood Lake.
Eastwood Lake, and they're involved in that. So I think we're going to have nine vintage speedboats in the parade, which is interesting. That's why I'm getting kind of nervous about the size of it all. And it's going to be a full house. It's going to be interesting and a good time for all. So I'm looking forward to it.
Gene, while everyone's here, I want to thank you for picking up the parade this year. Sally Rotter had always headed up the parade, and she did a great job. She handed the torch over this year, and Gene took it over along with Sharon. So just don't screw up, okay?
Wait till after the parade to see if I'm willing to do it next year.
Sunday.
Yeah, that's always a given, you know. And as you said, one of the critical things of the parade is actually blocking off 571 out by the airport early enough and keeping people from shooting through and coming out. And last year, I think year before last, they had an individual who actually went down and almost clipped one of the wings trying to go by them. So. We got to be real careful with that because we don't want to do anything to jeopardize their involvement in the parade and get anybody injured. So, and one last thing, just to know, I know since we're on camera, I'll get this out. I think it's pretty been well known over the years that we do not permit any type of political election advertisements in the parade. If you're an incumbent and you're already in office, you can actually be in the parade and with a holding office, but we do not allow any election signs to run in the parade, so just information. Yes? Yes. Next meeting, Thursday night?
Yeah, our next festival meeting is this Thursday at the firehouse at 7 o'clock.
We could use plenty of volunteers, yes please.
Okay, all set with that. Okay, other business, anyone else? Any other business? Yes, Mr. Kravitz.
I want to say some really positive things. The crop walk was yesterday, and we didn't have a whole lot of people walking. However, we did collect quite a bit of money. I don't know what the donation was, but I know it's really close to our $10,000 goal. I want to thank all the businesses that in the city here, New Carlisle, and also in Park Lane, that has helped to achieve that goal. And I did what I said I was going to do in the very beginning. You know, remember at the beginning of the spring, I said it looked a little trashy around some of the streets. And I got some trash bags and I start picking up trash. And I want to thank the citizens because, I only picked up two small bags of trash, and that's within 5 miles. We walked 5K, 5 to 10K around. And so, I want to thank, the citizens, they must have been really picking up, keeping their yards. And I bumped into two people, not just then, but one of them is Bill. He's our new neighbor. He just moved into the city, and he loves the neighborhood. He said, "I love this neighborhood. I'm so quiet, so quiet." And I also, in the prayer circle that I'm with, there was a guy a family just moved on to Prentice. An apprentice, and he was talking about how great the city is, and he does love being here and being with neighbors, and he knows his neighbors. And that's one of the things I said. Do you know your neighbors? He says, "Yes, I do." I just want to thank the citizens for welcoming new people.
You want to talk about the Brethren Church and their meal?
No, because you were part of it. That's why I don't want.
Well, that's fine. You can just you're going to do
the
it again.
The Brethren Church, the Church of the Brethren for 10 years. We started out as a little Lenten project. Now we've gone on for 10 years, every Wednesday between 5 and 6, we give out a free meal. And it just come hungry. You don't have to be poor, don't have to be rich, you don't have to be just hungry. Randy has done it for 1 week. Last week, the mayor and his group in the Rotary, and I want to thank Rotary, for doing it. Each week we have a different organization taking over the kitchen. I do the cooking, they do the serving. My best part is I do the cooking. I don't like to serve. But we've got different organizations. And we're just trying to help the community the best we can. you know, and I know there's a lot of hungry people out there, and just come on Wednesday night with your neighbor and talk to, you know, just talk to each other. You know, that's what the whole purpose of the thing is. And I thank you, Mayor. You know.
Anyone else? Any other business? Anyone? Audience, anything? Anybody like to say other business? Okay. Would you go ahead and read the rest of what we have here, please?
Just as a reminder, the open door session, which occurs the second Tuesday of each month, 3 p.m. at the City Building, it's a chance for any citizens to come and meet face-to-face with the representative from Congressman Boehner's office. We already talked about the Heritage of Flight Festival and covered all the details of that. I have Crime Watch meeting on the agenda, but I do not know. Who has a calendar in front of
us? Tomorrow.
No.
I could have swore on a driveway board and said tomorrow. Oh, wait a minute. That's my calendar.
No, they've had the one for September already.
13th. 13th.
And that Wednesday, October the 8th. October 14th.
Go ahead and disregard the city website that says it's tomorrow. I'll fix that in the morning.
That occurs at 6:30 here at the Smith Park Shelter House. And Mayor, that's all I have under other business.
Thank you, sir, for your help. Executive session, there's none tonight. One more chance for anybody in the audience, council, anything at all? Vic's not here tonight.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes,
sir.
Mr. Mayor, I have a question on one of the ordinances that I think it was the first reading or it's the emergency ordinance about the propane. Maybe I should ask Randy or Mr. Bridge, do you put that out for bids or how do you choose who you're going to buy your propane from?
I wasn't even listening to you, I'm sorry.
Well, I get that a lot from you. The question was on the propane, do you put that out for bids, or how do you choose who you buy your propane from, or have you always bought it from Farrell?
I know we've bought it from Farrell for numerous years.
We had bid for a while. Farrell was always the lowest being right down here with delivery.
Yeah.
And so we just continue to use them, and sometimes the price goes down, sometimes it goes up.
And it actually went down 39 cents.
30 cents.
Yeah, 39 cents. Okay.
It's the proximities right now.
I was just wondering if you just use them or, mm-hmm. you know, if that price was competitive or whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you. Now I will, yes.
Mr. Mayor, motion that we adjourn.
We are adjourned. Thank you.